Hello, my dear students. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and safe at your home. Welcome to Madhi English School Online Education. I am glad to welcome all my dear students to the new session of mathematics. We are going to start our day with a meaningful thought. Knowledge will bring you opportunity to make a difference. What does it mean by that? Knowledge gives you understanding what is good or what is bad. You make difference between good and evil. So my dear students, don't stop learning. Continue your journey to become educated, to achieve the knowledge. Before we start, everyone sit straight, make your back straight. Very good. How are you all? Fine? Enjoying the revision? Understanding everything? Very nice. Each and everyone is writing with me, na? Everyone prepares the notes, na? Very good. So, my dear students, you all are ready for writing work? Very good. Write down today's date and day in this corner. Write the heading Revision Essay 1. As I told you in each and every lecture that before we start our lecture, you should write the heading so that you all can understand what you are going to learn or write. Before we start, one more time, let me familiar with you with paper style. Question number 1 is fill in the blanks. Question 2 is write number names from 51 to 100 numbers. Question 3, write between numbers. Question 4, add the following. My dear students, we already completed question 1, revision. Also, we have completed revision of write number names, in which we completed number names 51 to 100. We have completed revision of question number 3, write between numbers. Also completed question number 4, add the following. Question 5 is subtract the following. Question 6, problem sums. Question 7, complete the table. In previous lecture, we make revision of subtract the following, which was incomplete. And I told you that in next lecture, we will complete the topic. For question complete the table, you have to prepare tables 1 to 5. We have already completed tables 1 to 7. So I hope now you all are ready with tables 1 to 5. Though in previous lecture we make revision of complete the table of 1 and 2. So today we are going to make revision of subtract the following. As I told you just now that in previous lecture we make half of the revision for the same question. So, first of all, let's see what we have completed in previous lecture, and after that, we will finish the topic today onwards. Okay? So, my dear students, get ready for writing work. Take the book, pencil, each and every essential stationery, so that you all can copy the work. Okay? everyone write the heading subtract the following subtract subtract the following look my dear students today onwards we are going to make complete the revision of subtract the following now the ball is in your court my dear students you all have to write with me so that you can copy the revision with me okay before we start let me inform about subtraction so my dear students tell me who remains what is subtraction tell me is anyone remember what is subtraction who remembers that In maths, to subtract means to take away from a group or a number of things. What is the meaning of subtraction? To subtract means to take away or to cross out from a group or a number of things. In the subtraction problem, 7 minus 3 is equal to 4. The number 7 is the minute, the number 3 is the subtrahend, and the number 4 is the difference. Subtraction represent with this sign which is called minus. I hope the concept becomes clear to each and everyone. Sum number 1 is 8 minus 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 minus 5 means we have to cross out 5. 1, 2, 3. Now see how many objects are remaining there? 3, 4 and 5. Now we have to find out the remaining objects which are 1, 2 and 3. So 8 minus 5 is equal to 3. Next sum is 4 minus 2. For this we need 4 objects 1, 2, 3, 4 minus 2 means cross out 2, 1 and 2. Now see my dear students, the remaining objects are our answer. See how many objects are remaining there? There remains 1 and 2. So 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. If you remember, we have completed these sums in previous lecture. This is the revision for the same. 9 minus 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. We have 9 objects and now we have to cross out 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Look, how many objects are remaining there? There remains only 1. So, 9 minus 8 is equal to 1. I have drawn the objects here for your help. It is not compulsory that everyone should draw the objects. But yes, of course, if any of the students are unable to understand without drawing any objects, they can take the help for these objects. So that they can understand the concept well as they can count the sums properly. Okay, my dear? 13 minus 2. I told you before that this is the subtraction of single digit from double digit. So how can we solve this? Whenever we are going to make subtraction of two digit numbers. First of all, we have to start solving from ones column. In ones column, here we have 3 minus 2. What is the number? 3 minus 2. That means we need 3 objects. 1, 2 and 3. Minus 2. Minus means we have to take away or cross out 2. 1 and 2. Look, there remains only 1 object. So, 3 minus 2, we get only 1. And here we are going to solve the tens column. There is one only. Here we don't have any numbers. So 1 minus 0, we get the same number. 13 minus 2 is equal to 11. After that, we have 18 minus 5. First of all, as I told you before, that we have to solve the ones column. 8 minus 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Minus 5 means cross out 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See, there remains 1, 2 and 3 objects. 8 minus 5, we get 3. 1 is alone, so there comes only 1. In short, we can say that 18 minus 5 is equal to 13. 15 minus 2. First of all, we have to solve the ones column. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Minus 2, 1 and 2. There remains 1, 2 and 3 objects. 5 minus 2, we get 3. 1 is alone. So, there comes 1. In short, we can say that 15 minus 2 is equal to 13. My dear student, this was the quick revision of previous lecture. Now onwards, we are going to make revision of new sums. So, everyone, now you have to copy the sums with me. Be ready for your writing work. Write the sum 1919 minus 8. What is the sum? 19 minus 8. Make sure that you have to write number 8 in ones column. Leave the tens column and write number 8 at ones place. First of all, we are going to solve ones place 9 minus 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Minus 8 means cross out 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. See how many objects are remaining there? There remains only 1. So 9 minus 8, we get 1 only. Write down number 1 just below number 8 in ones column. Now solve the tens column 1. Minus 0 means here we have to write the number itself, which is 1. We can say that 19 minus 8 is equal to 11. Everyone, note down the sum with the answer. 19 minus 8 is equal to 11. Completed? Very good. Now, write the new sum, which is 13 minus 3. Our next sum is 13 minus 3. Everyone, copy the sum in your book properly. Completed, everyone? Now, tell me, what should I do now? First of all, we have to solve the ones column. which is 3 minus 3. 1, 2, 3. Minus 3 means I have to cross out 3 objects. 1, 2, 3. Now see, we don't have any remaining objects here. So what should I do? What will be the answer? If there is not any number remaining, then there comes number 0. 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. Move towards 10th column. There is 1 minus 0. What does it mean by? It means we have to write the number itself. There we have to write number 1. 13 minus 3 is equal to 10. Everyone, copy the answer in your book. Done, everyone? 13 minus 3, we get 10. Okay? Write the next sum, everyone. One, 11 minus 1. 11 minus 1. Completed your writing part, my dear students? So now what should I do? I have to solve the ones column first. Look, here we have 1 minus 1. This is 1. Minus 1 means I have to cross out 1. Now see, is there any object remaining? No. What does it mean by? It means there comes a 0. When there is not remaining any objects, there comes 0. In the other words, we can say that when we can subtract the number with the number itself, at the end there comes 0. Now move towards solving 10th column. There is 1 minus 0. What does it mean by? Whenever we are going to subtract a 0 from any of the number, we get the same number as an answer. That means there comes 1. 11 minus 1, we get 10. Everyone, copy the sums properly in your book, as this is the revision, so that it is most important thing that you all have to understand the concept properly. And yes, of course, you all have to make copy the sums properly in your book. Okay? Write down the sum. 11 minus 1, we get 10. Completed? Shall we move on? Very good. Write the next sum. 16 minus 4. Next sum is 16 minus 4. So now what should I do? First of all, we have to solve the ones column. Look, at ones column, here we have 6 minus 4. What does it means by? It means we need 6 objects here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay? Understand, everyone? minus 4. When you find this sign, what does it means by? This is the sign of subtraction and we can call it minus. When you see this sign, that means you have to cross out or take away. Here we have to cross out four objects. 1, 2, 3, 4. See how many objects are remaining there? There remains two objects. 6 minus 4 is equal to 2. Hence we have solved the ones column. Now let's move towards tens column. Here 1 is alone, so we have to write number 1. 16 minus 4 is equal to 12. I hope you all are writing with me and you all are understanding the concept. Okay? Note down the next sum. 19 minus 9. Write number 1 at tens place and number 9 at ones place. Minus 9. You have to write this 9 at ones place. Just below number 9. 19 minus 9. We need 9 objects to solve this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Minus 9 means cross out 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, there is not any object remaining. What does it mean? It means there comes a 0. 9 minus 9, we get 0. 1 minus 0, we get 1. 19 minus 9 is equal to 10. Okay? Is everyone understand? Write the next sum. 19 minus 7. Next sum is 19 minus 7. First of all, let's solve the ones column 9 minus 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Minus 7 means cross out 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. See how many objects are remaining there? There remains 1 and 2. 9 minus 7 is equal to 2. 1 minus 0, we get 1. 19 minus 7 is equal to 12. Everyone, copy the answer in your book. Now, write the next sum. 17 minus 5. Write the sum 17 minus 5. My dear students, while writing the sums, make sure that write the numbers on its proper place. Here, first of all, we are going to solve this ones column. 7 minus 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Minus 5 means cross out 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Look, there remains 1 and 2. 7 minus 5, we get 2. 1 minus 0, we get 1. 17 minus 5 is equal to 12. Understand everyone? Copy the sums properly in your book. 17 minus 5, we get 12. Okay? Shall we move on? Write the next sum. 5 minus 4. 5 minus 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now, what should I do? As our sum is 5 minus 4, I have to cross out 4. Let's do it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now see, how many objects are remaining there? There remains 1. 5 minus 4, we get 1. Is everyone copy the sum in your book? Very good. Now, write the next sum. 8 minus 6. Next sum is 8 minus 6. For this, we need 8 objects. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Minus 6 means cross out 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now see, how many objects are remaining there? There remains 1 and 2. That means 8 minus 6 is equal to 2. My dear students, this was the last sum of this revision session. So today here we have completed the revision of subtract the following. I hope you all understand the concept well, as well as you all have made the copy work properly. So now it's time to note down the homework. Write the homework. Write revision subtract the following one time in Maths Fair book. And of course, while writing the sum, make sure that you have to write the numbers on its proper place. At your home, everyone, stay safe, stay happy, take care of yourself. We will meet in the next lecture. Till then, thank you very much and bye-bye everyone.